Exactly. Well, it's something no doctor or patient wants to be a part of. Do nothing and face death or have surgery that could potentially paralyze. But brand new technology is changing the game for cancer patients and doctors alike. Inoperable tumors may not be inoperable anymore. Get this, Fox News Medical A-Team's Dr. Marc Siegel is here now. Truth in this? That's crazy.
Absolutely, Clayton. Because of the way tumors blend with the normal brain, a brain surgeon doesn't always know where the cancer ends and the brain begins. At risk, any number of functions, from motor skills to memory. But now hospitals like Henry Ford in Detroit are utilizing a new and exciting solution. It's called diffusion technology. I spoke with Henry Ford's chair of neurosurgery, Dr. Steve Kalkanis, to find out more. Take a look. Today, I am the patient, testing out the new diffusion technology on my own brain. This may look like an ordinary MRI machine, but the BrightMatter software analyzes these scans and turns images that once looked typical into the medical land of Oz.
So this is Dr. Siegel's brain. What are these red things and what's the blue and green?
That brings your brain to life. Those are all the different tracks inside the brain, and each one of them has different functions.
So the point here is, if there were a tumor here, you would see where it was.
We would then be able to overlay the functional images on top of where the problem is to pick a path to reach it most safely.
And you could show these images as you were operating on me?
Absolutely. These images are projected onto about 5 different screens in our operating room.
It's a color-coded GPS map of the brain.
In the old days, we had a plain static map, and if you had to go from point A to B, you just sort of figured it out. This technology tells you step by step how to get to point B, and along the way, if there's a construction zone or if there's a detour, it tells you well in advance where you should be going, and at the end, you have confirmation that you got there successfully.
It's giving new hope to what were just recently dire situations.
Many patients who were told, you know, we can't operate, it's too dangerous. We've been able to convert some of those cases to a case that we can actually perform surgery on.
Like 28-year-old Tiffany Crow, diagnosed with a brain tumor when she was just a teen. 10 years after her surgery, she suddenly lost motor skills in her left arm. The tumor was back.
Would I lose some of my ability in my hand? Would I lose some more weakness on my left side? So that was the scary part. A lot of people don't realize how important they are until they're gone. You can't just put your hair up in a ponytail. You can't zip your jacket. You can't tie your shoes.
Tiffany's neurosurgeon, Dr. Ian Lee, knew this new color-coded technology was essential for a successful surgery.
In Tiffany's case, we knew that the tumor was very close to her motor fibers, and so we had to be extra cautious. By knowing where the white matter tracks are, it really does give us a very good idea of where the danger lies.
And now?
Everything that they could see was removed, and I don't have permanent weakness at this point.
Show me.
I can squeeze your hand pretty
tight. That's pretty strong.
I can touch all my fingers together, something I couldn't do 2 weeks ago.
For brain surgeons at Henry Ford and elsewhere, this is only the beginning.
We're living in probably the most exciting age ever in the history of neurosurgery. The technology of tomorrow, I think we're closer to Star Trek than we've ever been before.
This is very good news for the 78,000 brain tumor cases expected to be diagnosed this year, according to the American Brain Tumor Association. Clayton, the day before surgery, she couldn't zip up her jacket. The day after, she could.
It becomes a death sentence at a close friend who just passed away 2 weeks ago from a brain tumor. And there's little research around this, little money that goes to this area. This is a huge frontier.
We need more money, and someday it's going to be something we hold in our hand like Star Trek, and we can look into the brain and see exactly where to operate.
Unbelievable. Thanks, Doc.
Great to see you.
Amazing stuff. Thanks, Doc.